Hello everyone, this is Ed Nurisa and you are watching NDH Prime Prime. First, the headlines. Two extremely skilled in an encounter by Assam Rifles. Dimahasao DMCC sit in protest against the withdrawal of postal stamp of Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi. First Dimash Appreciates come Talented Cultural Program at Maibank. Ganesh Chaturthi celebrated in Harangajao. DSCG organized 18 Dimasa Freshman Social Camp Get Together 2015. Flood caused Assam to become a point of human trafficking. Now, the news in details. Two extremists of Jatikin Aiso Bojom JNB group killed in an encounter by Assam Rifles on 22nd of September 2015 between Lunding Khelma and Choto Manja village under Langting police station. One of them is identified as Hamson, commander of Jatikin Aiso Bojom JNB, and the other is yet to identify. Army recovered one AK-56 three pistols and an air gun from them. Dimahasao District Mahila Congress Committee sit in protest against the decision of the NDA government to revoke the order of continuance of the existing postal stamps of Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi, former Prime Minister of India, in front of the Deputy Commissioner Office, Haflong, on 22nd of September 2015. Srimati Ranu Langdasa, Executive Member of North Kachhapur Autonomous Council and the President of District Mahila Congress Committee, said that Mahila Congress Committee will continue the protest till the NDA government changes your decision. Chief Executive Members of North Kachhapur Hills Autonomous Council, Sri Devajit House and Sri Mahindra Kempra, Executive Members of North Kachhapur Hills Autonomous Council and Vice Chairman of Planning Board, NCU's Autonomous Council, Sri Tulsi Prasad Upadhyaya, were also seen in the protest along with the DMCC members.
हम लोग महिला कांग्रेस लोग यहाँ में जमा हुआ क्योंकि हम लोग ये जो हम लोग का बीजेपी लेड गवर्नमेंट वो जो पॉलिसी लीड कर रहा है वो जैसे हम लोग को माँ बाबा समान इंदिरा गांधी जी राजीव गांधी जी वो लोग का पोस्टल स्टैम्प जो अभी यो कर रहा है ना विद्रोह कर रहे हैं वो हम लोग फुल्ली प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं क्योंकि हम लोग को माँ बाबा समान हम लोग को देश रक्षा करने वाला लोग उनको ऐसा स्टैम्प पोस्टल स्टैम्प बंद करने से हम लोग आगे भी करा है अभी भी करेगा कल भी करेगा प्रोटेस्ट और हमेशा हम लोग जब तक सक्सेस नहीं होगा हम लोग प्रोटेस्ट करेगा महिला कांग्रेस
इसके विरोध में जो कि अभी के जो एनडीए गवर्नमेंट है सेंटर में उन्होंने एक उत्पटांग सा एक डिसीजन लिया है जो पोस्टल का जो टिकट है उनमें हमारे आदरणीय पूर्व प्रधानमंत्री जो एक आयरन लेडी के नाम से प्रचलित है आप सब जानते हैं देशवासी जानते हैं इंदिरा गांधी जी और हमारे जो मॉडर्न इंडिया और जो आज का जो कंप्यूटर वर्ल्ड लेने वाले राजीव गांधी जी का पोस्टर मान उनका जो पोस्टल है स्टाम्प उसको उन्होंने बंद करने का डिसीजन लिया इसके विरोध में हम इकट्ठा होकर खड़ा हुए हैं और एक आपके माध्यम से मैं मोदी सरकार को पूछना चाहूँगा देश को एक उल्लू बना के आपने सत्ता तो हासिल किया बोला देश में कांग्रेस को हटाओ कांग्रेस मुक्त कराओ देश में शांति आएगा देश में समृद्धि आएगा देश से काला धन आएगा वापस और देशवासियों को इतना सौगात मिलेगा आने वाले दिन में सामानों के दाम जो सामान है खाद्य पदार्थ इसका दाम आधा होगा तो आपके माध्यम से आज मैं पूछना चाहूँगा यूपीए सरकार के टाइम में जो दाल की कीमत 80 रुपया था आज वो बढ़ के 150 से 160 यही है अच्छे दिन तो देश को दरिद्री की ओर लेके जा रहे हैं अरे कॉरपोरेट जो बिजनेस हैं जो बड़े बड़े बिजनेसमैन इनके लिए इनका ध्यान रहता है पूरा ध्यान और जो गरीब है किसान है छोटे व्यक्ति जो है माध्यम वर्ग के जो हमारे सिटीजन है सबके विरोध में ये काम कर रहे हैं बड़े वालों को धनी के धनी बना रहे हैं अरे गरीब को गरीब मुंगेरी लाल के हसीन सपने मोदी साहब ने बहुत देखा है लेकिन ये हसीन सपने ज्यादा दिन नहीं टिकेगा आने वाले दिन में जो आपने आज ये काम किया है इसका जरूर आप लोग को भुगतान करना पड़ेगा। 5 साल के लिए आप लोग रहे हैं, लेकिन सदैव के लिए आप लोग नहीं है। जिस पार्टी ने देश को आजादी लेके आया वो इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस। आज मैं आपके माध्यम से पूछना चाहूंगा कि देश के लिए बलिदानी होने वाले आपके भाजपा सरकार में से कौन है? एक आदमी का आप लोग चेहरा दिखाइए। हमारा पार्टी ने देश आजाद करने के लिए बहुत सा बलिदान दिया है, तब जाके आज देश आजाद हुआ है। खुली हवा में हमने सांस लेने का हमें मौका मिला है। आज आप लोग पार्टी कीजिए, कोई बात नहीं, लेकिन देश के साथ आप लोग गद्दारी मत कीजिए। डेमोक्रेसी है, आज बीजेपी है, ये हम भी मानते हैं, कल हम फिर दोबारा आएंगे। लेकिन आप लोग जो पॉलिसी कर रहे हैं इसके हम लोग विरोध हैं, और कभी भी आपका पॉलिसी हम लोग सक्सेस होने नहीं देंगे। जय हिंद, जय कांग्रेस।
All Dimasa Students Union ATSU Maibang branch organized Dimasa Freshers Cum Talent Search cultural program for the first time ever in the Maibang subdivision in Maibang Higher Secondary School Auditorium Hall on 20th of September 2015. Mr. Ashok Landasa graced the occasion as the chief guest, and other dignitaries like JL Jidung, Suchitra Singha, Kalpita Kemprai, Uttam Langdasa, General Secretary of ATSU Dimahasau, and many other senior citizens of Maibang also witnessed the program. The program began with the lighting of lamp by the chief guest on the program, followed by a brief meeting related to the educational system of the subdivision. The chief guest in his short speech advised the students to give emphasis on study, and also thanked ATSU Maibang branch for organizing such a program for the first time ever in the subdivision. Students from different higher secondary school and college from different part of Maibang subdivision attended the program at large. The spectators were also amused by traditional dance displayed by the students. And at last but not the least, Ms. Navanita Nunisa sang songs. The program ended with vote of thanks by Myring Dao Johori, president of ATSU Maibang branch. Ganesh Chaturthi was celebrated in Harangajo with great enthusiasm from 16 to 19 September 2015. It is the Hindu festival celebrated in honor of the Lord Ganesha. The festival is also known as Vinayak Chaturthi and is in the Hindu calendar month of Bhadrapada. The date usually falls between August and September. The festival was organized by the Bazar Committee of Harangajaw. Executive members of Northern Chahar Hills Autonomous Council like Nirmal Langdasa, Prakanda Warisa, Mahindra Kempra, and many others members of Congress Mandal Committee were also seen visiting the shrine to take the blessing of Lord Ganesha on the occasion. People believe that the festival is celebrated in such a grand way in the district Dimahasau only in Harangajaw, as the festival is not that popular in the district. While in other part of the country, it is one of the most popular festivals. Dimasa Students Community Guwahati DSUG organized its 18th Dimasa Freshmen Come Get Together at Shield Program, Panjabari, Guwahati on 20th of September 2015, with P.B. Acharya, Governor of Assam, as the chief guest. Dignitaries like Dr. Mridul Hazarika, Vice Counselor of Guwahati University, Srimati Marvi Hazar, retired IS Commissioner of Health Service Assam, Dr. Dhruva Hoja, retired Director of Health Service Assam, Mr. Panindra Jidung, Director of Higher Education Assam, General Secretary of Dimasa Students Union, President of All Dimasa Students Union, President of Greater Guwahati Karbi Students Association, also witnessed the program as the guest of honor. The guests were welcomed in Dimasa traditional way with Kharam Muri, and a batch of students sung national anthem before the chief guest takes his seat. After ritual taking and felicitation of the guest, a sketch of Veer Samudan Fonglo was presented to the Governor of Assam by the president of DSUG Mandeep Fonglo, and a sketch of a Dimasa couple with traditional dress was also presented to the vice counselor of Guwahati University by the general secretary of DSUG Sarparas Hojai. Later, the lamp was lighted by the guest, and a welcome speech was delivered by the DSUG general secretary Sarparas Hojai. The chief guest in his speech exhorted to encourage the students to focus on their studies, and also assured the students the DSUG office in the Guwahati University and DSUG hostel will be provided within 2 to 3 years. In his speech, he also lays stress importance on the youth, as the youth is the backbone of the nation and will be the identity of the community in the days to come. Assam is now a major source for human trafficking rackets based in Delhi NCR, mainly due to destruction caused by flood and its aftermath. Almost every year, and the children trafficked from there are mostly placed in domestic helps at residence either in the national capital region or town in Haryana. According to the reports, many who fail to be placed anywhere are later forced into prostitution or begging. Assam is also a transit point for children who are trafficked from Arunachal Pradesh and Meghalaya. However, these two states are targeted particularly by human trafficking racket based in Kolkata and Mumbai. This is all we have in our news bulletin. For more updates, log on to our website www.newsdimahasau.today. Thank you for being with us. Keep watching NDH.